give you the latest, the juiciest, and the hottest entertainment news, mapa local man o international. Yan ang hatid namin sa inyo because here's a countdown. You shouldn't miss the new normal. You can't resist. It's a Friday. Let's start with number 10. One project is discontinued. I'm talking about Warner Brothers, Wonder Twins production. No more Wonder Twins. That seems to be the question in a lot of people's mind as it has been reported that the DC-based feature has been shelved. Bing, bing, bing. That's according to multiple sources. As per The Hollywood Reporter, the project is supposed to be led by KJ Apa and Isabel May. Sources say that the reason of the decision to shut down the production was because Wonder Twins was too niche and the project budget was too high for an HBO Max movie. Bing, bing, bing. Well, if you're wondering what Wonder Twins is about, it's a story of a pair of alien siblings, Zan and Jaina. And yeah, I think the recipe for this is just to have great writers, I guess, and baka hindi nga pasok sa budget. It all boils down to that. But for top 9, we're going to talk about this hottie. Channing Tatum is taking it to the screen. Yes, he is set to star in the adaptation of his children's book. Ding, ding, ding. That is so cute! Channing Tatum's children's book will become a feature film, and he will be the lead star, no less than himself. The one and only Sparkella will become a live-action film telling the story of a father and a daughter and how they fell in love into the infinite surprising world of the girl's imagination. And that's according to Variety. Ding, ding, ding. No info yet on who will play the role of the daughter, but the book was written by Channing and, well, it was released in 2021. The production dates for the film are yet to be announced. And yes, the key there is, again, a wonderful writer, a wonderful budget, and a great casting. Well, that's the recipe for success nowadays, right, when it comes to the box office. But his book, Sparkella, is really something interesting. I like the storyline. How about you guys? Tom Cruise received a standing ovation at the Cannes Film Festival. Yup, Tom Cruise in his movie Top Gun Maverick made a remarkable entrance at the Cannes Film Fest, wherein a fighter jet flew above while emitting blue-red colors of the French flag. Kung hindi ba naman pasabog si Tom Cruise, ewan ko na lang kung ano. Well, but it still proved to be Tom's moment as he and the movie received 5 to 6 minute long standing ovation after its screening. Boom! It took everyone out of this world. And after that, it was announced that Tom was a recipient of the Palme d'Or. A surprise for him! He deserves it! He's the biggest star in the world, undoubtedly. Top Gun Maverick is set to be released in local theaters next week. That is the 25th. And congratulations, Tom. We will screen the film tonight. I'll see you how it goes. Follow me on my socials for that. And we're going to talk about it here on Celebrity Top 10. Minions, The Rise of Gru film and soundtrack is out on July. So Decca Records today announced the original motion picture soundtrack for Illumination's Minions, The Rise of Gru, the new action comedy from the biggest animated franchise in history. Set in the 70s, Minions, The Rise of the Gru tells the origin story of how Gru, Oscar nominee Steve Carell, the world's greatest supervillain, first met his iconic minions, forged cinema's most despicable crew, and faced off against the most unstoppable criminal force ever assembled. Well, guys, it is the soundtrack, going back to this, is produced by 2022 Grammy Producer of the Year Jack Antonoff, features star-studded lineup Diana Ross, her, and many more. I'm so excited. And yes, it's set for July to coincide with the film's global theatrical release. But right now, we're going to give you a Squid Game 2 news. There's a date. Two dates. It's a toss-up between 2023 and 2024. I'm okay with 2024 with Squid Games 2, just as long as I know how hardworking our friends in South Korea are and producing the best entertainment they could. And I don't want this to disappoint because Squid Game 2 or Squid Game 1 is just out of this world. And I want to know what's going to happen in the second one, right? How they will stretch the story. So the creator, Wong Dong-hyuk, said in an interview with Vanity Fair that the series is expected to return next year or next. 3 pages of ideas for season 2 are still up and in talks with Netflix. And according to Dong-hyuk, the second season will question if humanity can conquer as a united front, in contrast to season 1, where they attack one another. Squid Games is such a big hit for Netflix that even warranted a lot of recognition from different award-giving bodies. All right, we're halfway on the show. Hello to the All In Addicts and OMJ supporters. Hello to you guys. Happy Friday. There is Inay Kopo tomorrow, 10 a.m. to 11 a.m. with Pat Fernandez. I will be your host there here on 1PH, which you can view 10 p.m. here, 4:15 p.m. 1 News on Radio 592.3 News FM. Thank you for joining us. We're halfway on the show. Let's talk about this. We're talking about Ricky Montgomery, who looks back on the success of Line Without a Hook. So the indie pop artist Ricky Montgomery shares his playful, deeply personal It's 2016 Somewhere EP via Warner Records. But one single he released earlier is getting a lot of buzz, especially on TikTok. At doon talaga pumuputok yung mga kanta. Take a listen.
Line Without a Hook had kind of a mixture of inspirations. I would say I was just leaving high school and kind of entering into college at the time, and I was leaving kind of a difficult household situation, and I had gone through like a big breakup. And so it was the kind of this cathartic release of a lot of different emotions at once. And the song Line Without a Hook isn't about one thing in particular. It's more about that feeling of being free and being able to kind of purge all these pent up emotions that I've been feeling for a lot of years in my teenage years. And I think the arrangement reflects that too. It's like the first time I ever used strings. We had like a live violin player do a lot of playing on that one. It was my first big adventurous song where I tried to be ambitious with the arrangement and everything. And I think that paid off. I think people liked that. So.
Since the release, the following of Line Without a Hook grew rapidly and is now close to 1 billion global streams. Check it out.
It's pretty much exclusively because of TikTok that all of that happened and continues to happen. I'm very lucky for that. It's been like 2 years now that this song just does not go down. It's amazing. My thoughts on that are that I'm very thankful. You know, I don't really have much to say other than just me expressing gratitude over and over again. I'm just really, really thankful.
Ricky is currently on tour. Let's see if we will meet him right here in the Philippines. Oh my gosh, John Mayer. Well, he did join Alexander 23 on stage during the Boston show. Ding, ding, ding. Wrapping up on John Mayer's Sob Rock tour at the TD Garden in Boston, rising artist Alexander 23 was joined by this icon for a surprise duet of Everybody Wants to Rule the World. Anyway. Kayo maglipat ng channel kahit kumanta ako. Ganon! Char! But anyway, the Chicago-bred singer, songwriter, producer, multi-instrumentalist led on vocals while John did shredding on the guitar. Here's a glimpse. Alexander 23 is set to head to the UK and Ireland for shows supporting the pop upstart Tate McRae. Later this year, he will play sets at festivals including Lollapalooza in Chicago and Life is Beautiful in Las Vegas. Hwang In-yup is coming to Manila. Get ready for the True Beauty Stars' first fun meet event in the Philippines. Mark your calendars as Korean K-drama star Wang In-yup is visiting the country. Wang In-yup initially pursued modeling before making his acting debut with a lead role in the web drama WHY, after which he did appear in a number of television dramas, including Freshman, The Tale of Nokdu, 18 Again. He gained further recognition in True Beauty, which is, of course, based on line webtoon of the same title. The Hallyu star continues to rise with his latest series, The Sound of Magic, now number one to Netflix. Well, the visit's going to be at June 19th at the New Frontier Theater. Let's check that out. Dalawa na for Ed Sheeran. Well, he is welcoming a baby girl once again. Say hello, hello, hello. The Grammy-winning singer and songwriter revealed in his Instagram account that his wife, Cherry Seaborn, well, they're now parents of two. He did show this off by posting a photo of white booties neatly laid on a brown blanket. Their firstborn, Lyra Antarctica, is 1 year old. Now, congratulations. That is happy news. But yes, everyone is enjoying right now. Rihanna's moment coming up, number one. Rihanna gives birth to a baby boy. Rihanna and A$AP Rocky welcomed their baby boy, according to reports. Well, according to TMZ, Rihanna gave birth last week with the baby boy's name, well, is yet to be revealed. She did break the news about her pregnancy earlier, just right after she was potted doing some photo shoots showing off her baby bump. We'll keep you posted about this story, but yep, welcome to the mom club, Riri. Before we end, we do have a general reminder for everybody. Get your boosters. Well, that's a reminder. Get your boosters, wear a mask, disinfect, practice social distancing. That's it. I'll see you on Monday, mga kapatid, makalista, makikountdown. Mondays to Fridays, 4:15 p.m. One News, 10 p.m., 1 p.h. We're on Radio 592.3 News FM. Read up my article in the Philippine Star every Saturdays. Please grab the paper. Thank you so much, guys. I love you. This is Celebrity Top 10.